opportunity to begin again. You still have the rest of this day. I don't know what time it is for you right now. It is late for me, but it is never too late to turn your day around. It is never too late to turn your day around. It is never too late to turn your day around. So, with that being said, I promised you guys that I was going to do a video today that is a little bit personal attention, but with that, I wanted to relay a message to you that I felt in my spirit to share today. As you guys know or do not know, I blog. I have a website called UniverseBlessYou.com, UniverseBlessYou.com, and on this website, I share blog posts, and these blog posts are related to how you can feel more blessings, receive more blessings from the universe, and just be and live more grateful despite what you may be going through in your life. I know that it is difficult sometimes to see the good, to see the things in life that are blessings when we are going through so many different things all at once. Life can be extremely overwhelming sometimes. It is. I know. It is hard sometimes. It is really hard. Life is not easy. But there are blessings in disguise all over the place. If you allow yourself to see them, if you give yourself these tunnel vision glasses towards your blessings, you will start to see. How truly blessed you are, and how your situation is just temporary. Your situation is just temporary. Your situation is temporary. Okay? You will not always be going through what you're going through. You will not always be going through what you're going through. It's going to be okay. It's going to get better. It's going to get better. It's going to get better. I know this to be true. I want you to know that it's true. Okay? So, with that being said, I wanted to share a little message on forgiveness. Now, it is extremely important to forgive yourself in order to love and truly love yourself. You have to allow yourself to forgive yourself for the mistakes made in the past. You are not perfect. No one is. In an imperfect world, there is no such thing as a perfect person. I always say that. I think it's super important to remember. That is something that I live by. That is something I continuously remind myself of. I used to get on myself for not being perfect. I was what some people would call a perfectionist, and I let that go. I let it go. Sometimes it tries to creep back into my life, but I know that in an imperfect world, there is no such thing as a perfect person. There is beauty in being imperfect, okay? So just remember that. And with that being said, I'm not talking about self-forgiveness today. I will talk about it in another video if you guys so request. But I'm going to talk about forgiving others. And in specific, forgiving those who do not say sorry. That's a hard one. It's very tough. And I'm going to read from my lovely book. This is my newest book. Was addition to my journals, and I am using it to write all of my affirmations, all of my positive thinking, all of the things out of reach on my first page. This book is dedicated to all things greatness, my visions, my goals, my creations, and my accomplishments. I wrote this down a few days ago. I just got this book. A lovely friend of mine gave it to me. So with that being said, and isn't it gorgeous? So what it says in the front is, this world is but a canvas to our imagination. It is a quote by Thoreau? I don't know if I read that correctly. If you know the author, please forgive me. Now, with that being said, I'm going to read to you briefly what I wrote, and then I'm just going to move on from that and share with you my thoughts on forgiveness of those who don't say sorry. Okay? Forgiving people who don't say sorry. Let's talk about it. Forgiving others can be extremely difficult. Many of us have experienced some unforgivable things that can be very hard to move on from. And I said unforgivable in quotes. At some point in everyone's life, it will be hard to forgive someone. We are human. Our souls feel things deeply, and it's okay to feel hurt when something affects you negatively. What's not okay is to continue holding on to that hurt instead of dealing with it. Healing and dealing with hurt is a necessary part of your growth and journey. But how do we deal and heal with pain caused by others? One important thing to realize is that your emotions and feelings are valid. If you are angry, don't just dismiss and suppress it. If you feel an urge to cry, don't just suck it up, but let it out. The problem with holding everything in and bottling up your emotions is that eventually it will explode. Think of a balloon. If you fill it with too much air, it will pop. If you fill up with too many suppressed feelings, your meltdown will flood your soul. And just like a balloon, you will explode. Or I said, you will break in this. So that is how I started my blog. I have not yet posted it, so you guys are the first to hear those words. And I thought that it was very important to reflect on that because I used to struggle a lot with forgiveness. I used to struggle a lot with not only forgiveness of myself, but forgiveness of people that just didn't apologize for the pain that they caused me. I have been through many different trials and tribulations in my life, as I'm sure you have as well. Maybe for some of you, it has been bullying. Maybe you were bullied as a child. Maybe you're bullied now. Maybe people didn't understand you. Maybe you were different and people didn't treat you the same way that they treated people that they cared about. Maybe you have family members that didn't treat you with the love and respect that you deserve. It happens. Unfortunately, there's a lot of hurt people in this world. And I don't know if you know, but hurt people. Let me repeat that. Hurt people. What that means is that sometimes when people are hurting, they do not know how to properly treat others. They do not know how to love because they do not love themselves. And when this happens and when there is a broken soul in that way, a lot of times these people will mistreat others. And it's not because it brings them joy. Maybe sometimes a little bit of it is that it brings them some type of satisfaction. Some type of satisfaction. Maybe sometimes they feel like, well, this happened to me. And maybe that's their anger with the world. And they just, you know, take it out on others. This happens so often in life. This is why we see so many terrible things happening in the world. We hear it on the news. We hear it in the streets. We hear it when we're on our way to work. We see it. Sometimes we experience it with strangers, people that we never did anything to, right? We don't understand why people do the things that they do. And sometimes it's not for us to understand. And sometimes it's not for us to receive an apology from those people. Sometimes it takes us being the bigger person and understanding that that was not our fault. You have to understand that when you are hurt by somebody deeply, it isn't your fault. Do not take blame, and sometimes it's not even their fault. You have to forgive people, for they do not know. Sometimes they don't know any better. Sometimes they weren't taught any better. Sometimes they've never experienced love, and it is difficult for them to give it out into the world, and they became their enemy. A lot of people make that mistake. They become what they did not like in other people, and it's a shame, and it's not fair. It's really not fair, but it's not for us to decide their fate. It's not for us to decide when it's their time to say sorry and when it's their time to change. It's not our journey, and we have to realize that in order for us to move on and continue in our journey, we have to find it in our hearts to forgive. Even the unforgivable, even the people that are not forgiving in their own lives, even the people that did not say sorry, okay? That doesn't mean that it's going to happen overnight. I'm not saying that tomorrow you're going to wake up and you're going to go, wow, I've feel completely healed from that pain that I was caused by somebody else. And wow, I forgive them. I'm not saying that it's gonna happen overnight. Rome was not built in a day. And I understand that some of the things that people have done to us are just years of torture or years of going through in our minds and playing it back and not understanding. And maybe you're still not, don't understand why those things happen to you. And you might be upset, and it's okay to be upset. You have to feel those things and deal with those things. You cannot suppress your feelings. I'm not saying that you should continue to be angry. I think it's important that you find it within yourself to learn how to forgive, but also how to deal with the things that you went through. It's not easy, darling. And I do not know all the answers. I do not know how to deal. I know that a lot of people use therapy. A lot of people might use friends and positive affirmations like I do, self-help books. There's so many different things. Yoga, any type of exercise, healthy eating, healthy living. You living your best life is the best revenge for those who hurt you. Showing yourself that you can move past that hurt and be a 10 times better person than the person that hurt you is the best revenge. The best revenge is you moving forward, is you showing yourself that you can and will move forward, live your life, be prosperous, okay? That is something that you can do. You can do it. It's not gonna happen overnight. It's not going to be something that is easy. It's going to be difficult. And some days might be easier than others. Some days are going to be harder than others. There might be things, you know, PTSD is real. Post-traumatic stress disorder is real. So when you go through things that are traumatizing, post-traumatic stress disorder is a real thing. Depression is a real thing that can be caused by those things. I'm not saying that it's going to be easy for you to get over those things. There might be certain triggers that might remind you of that. But I want you to get to a place where you are able to, if something triggers that and it arises in your soul that you remember those things and it comes up, you're able to look that pain in the face and smile and say, I'm already past that hurt. I already dealt with it. I already forgave that person who was not sorry. I forgave and I let it go. Because that's what happens when you forgive somebody, even when they don't apologize, and you let it go. You let go of that burden. You let go of that baggage that you carried. I don't know how long you've been carrying that baggage, but it's time to release it. Because it's holding you down and it's holding you back from being the best you that you can be. So forgive those even though they're not sorry. Forgive them even if they're not sorry. Forgive them even if they're not sorry. And it's not to forgive them for them. It's to forgive them for you. It's to forgive them for you and for your healing and for your life to be better. Okay? I don't know if this is something that is resonating with you, if you feel this message at all. I hope that you do. I know that all of us have things in our life that was painful. And you know what? It sucks. I know it does. You didn't deserve that. You didn't deserve that pain. But you are stronger. You are better than that situation. You are more than your pain. Okay? Continue to heal and deal. Do not suppress your feelings. If you need to cry, cry. Okay? Forgive. Forgive yourself. Realize it's not your fault. And forgive those who hurt you, even if they never apologize. Don't wait for that apology. Just forgive within yourself. Okay? So that even if that person does one day come back and say they're sorry, you didn't even need that. Okay? It might feel okay and good to hear, but you already did that work. You already put that work in for yourself, and you'll feel so accomplished when you finally reach that forgiveness. It's a beautiful feeling. I promise. promise you, because I've dealt with it, there has been people in this life that have hurt me so deeply that I allowed it to really hold me back in my life. It has held me back in so many ways I can't even express to you. But I was able to forgive even the people that I thought I would never forgive. I know you can do it too. If I could do it, you could do it. Okay. I'll talk to you tomorrow. I don't know what I'm going to talk to you about tomorrow, but I hope that you will join me. Okay? So, rest well.